Hi, my name's Casey Hill, Director of Engineering here at Dillon Rifle Company, ffdrc.com, and I'm here to talk to you about our OPAR Trigger.
Oh, would you like to swing on a star? You could be swinging on a star.
I had a conversation with Chris and Brody was sharing his story with me, and he was trying to wrap his head around how he could create something that would operate in a manner that would prevent accidental discharges. And as we talked about it, we found out that, you know, it's almost impossible to prevent an accidental discharge. The discussion led into how can we mitigate it? How can we reduce the amount of accidental discharges? And we ended up settling on the OPAR as it is right now. And with that, we were able to come up with our current CAD model, which is this right here. How do you fit something that's already designed and already has a pre-fit package, yet you provide a better trigger for safety and a better trigger for shooter engagement and things like that? So myself, our other engineer, Sean, and this machine shop, we're bouncing ideas back and forth. And between the three of us, we came up with a really simple idea, a simple mechanism that we could package this trigger in a single cassette and be able to do a drop-in trigger while providing the stability and the safety that Brody wanted to implement. In order to do that, we ended up settling on a slider mechanism on the inside. And it was as simple as that. Very similar to other mechanisms, but it's different in the sense that it's its own little mechanism outside. It's not just a lever. It's not just something that catches on the housing. This is something that had to be internalized because we couldn't just build a mechanism that interfaced with the lower. Putting all that into a package made us have to look at how tiny can we make everything while providing that stability. And that's where we settled on the actuating mechanism, the stop that's inside of that housing. And so everything's internalized because we wanted this trigger to be drop-in. We're a company that strives to have sleek looking designs. We're a company that wants to make things simple. We want to improve the shooter's experience. And a drop-in trigger is good for the armorers, and it helps out the users, the customers, when they buy it, they can just drop it in and go. And then they'll be able to know that it's a safer mechanism. It'll help mitigate some of those accidental discharges. If you imagine like your backpack, if you're hiking and you've got these things dangling all over the place, right? Well, if you have one of these little loops snag on your trigger, if you're out hunting or you're out on patrol, you've got your gear and your chest rigs up on your chest, moving around, or you're up in the helicopter and things are bouncing around, chances are something's gonna hit that trigger. This trigger, if the strap catches on it, it won't go bang. What requires the moment is the user's interface on the trigger, the secondary, to pull it, to actuate it, and to fire the weapon. The placement for your finger to have to be in that spot helps to control your accuracy. It helps you be reminded that you want to be precise. It's not just something you go in and go bang. We wanted to target that 5.5 pound range because we emphasize the law enforcement military side of things, and there are the thresholds with that. That was always the end game with this trigger from the onset, and being able to put that into the hands of the users that could use that in their day-to-day operations. Now we had to stress test our production facility. We had to stress test our inventory management system. We had to stress test the engineering design. You know, our machine shops are now not just, you know, onesie twosie machining parts. They're now having to build fixtures. They're now having to make sure that these designs can be robust enough that they can build and get repeated quality out of the system, and stress test our quality inspection systems. And all these things culminate into the grand scheme of producing this trigger, and we're now moving forward, and that's the fantastic thing. So that's the summary of how the trigger got here, and definitely excited for what's coming. There's so many things coming down the pipeline. The future is big for us.